Welcome to Dan ARG YouTube. This is the key poor man. Now be today topic with Apostle Alfred Uyinosa. The man where they talk him as he be, bring come. So make I leave you now, make you for hear from her. Enjoy the video.
My people, una, good morning. Oh, thank God for this wonderful day when he don't create. Now only one they put road, where road not day. And God go bless all of una for this wonderful day. Every day I've got to keep us alive. We could continue to the talk because information they powerful. With sound information, we go fit achieve great things for life and for destiny. This morning, quickly, I want to talk about our environment, the need for us to take care of ourselves and our environment. My brother Courage will join us any moment from now. So my uncle do the introduction. I will call him in, then he will talk to us briefly this morning. I discovered, say, for this COVID-19 palaver, there was strict measure for hand washing and other maintaining hygiene process. But I say, we don't agree wash hand again, especially for Nigeria. We don't wash hand again. We don't forget so soon. I believe, say, it will help us to maintain good hygiene. As we come back from work, we will go wash our hand before we enter house. It's supposed to be part of us. It's supposed to be part of us. But now, we don't, everybody don't go back to our normal life. We never really care again whether our hand dirty or not. And it's not good. It's not good. So now, which I don't observe, we never care again. All those measures, those precautions what they take, we never care again. We go food, buy things, we go chop and put up our mouth. We don't wash it. See, I will fit it really to maintain good hygiene to take care of ourselves, take care of our environment. Our environment too dirty. So people go drink ice cream, go throw the paper for road. So go eat banana, they go throw it for road. They go drink the water, they go throw it for road. All these things are not good. If they destroy our environment, make we learn to take care of ourselves. Make we maintain proper hygiene by washing our hands. Because washing your hands will help you. It will help prevent germs and other virus we will not see with our two naked eyes. I beg, make we go back to our hand washing. It is very, very important. You know, say Africa, they go say disease, not the key poor man. Yes, not true. Disease the key. Whether you like it or not, disease the key. I beg, make we go back to our life, which is to maintain a good hygiene. It is very, very important. On this note, I'll quick bring my brother come in now so that he could talk to us briefly for the next 10 to 15 minutes. So we need to really go back to our maintenance culture. It is very important. Make we learn to take care of ourselves, take care of our environment, take care of our family. Make we learn to wash our clothes, iron. All these things go really help us to kill nyamanyama and disease for our environment, especially hand washing. Because for this COVID-19 protocol, nobody would care again. Nobody would care again. So I beg, I say, make we really sit down, make we look this matter, because health is wealth. Cleanliness to godliness is what? Is wealth. So make we learn to take care of our environment, make we take care of ourselves. I beg. In most schools now, when they put this hand washer, people don't agree with that again. People don't agree with that again. So I beg, it will be very, very important. See, we maintain this hand washing. It will be very, very, very important. Make we go back to them. Because it will help to take care of a lot of sickness, because our hand, they carry a lot of dirty, a lot of nyama nyama. As we go outside, come back, before we enter the house, we supposed to wash our hand with soap and a running water. It will help us to maintain a good hygiene. Then, even money, each time you touch money will carry disease. Money carries some microorganism. When it be say, I know they see. I know they see. So make we learn to wash. My brother, good morning.
Apostle, good morning, sir.
How you doing?
Fine, sir. How do you night?
Fine, though. So we don't really talk about maintaining, make we take care of ourselves and our environment.
Okay.
Because I said for this COVID-19 palaver, everybody wash up before, but now we don't agree wash out again. Oh, we don't go back to our normal life. So if they go, say we still maintain the standard of washing our hands and taking care of our environment. So you as a head officer, make you throw match for this matter for the next 10 to 15 minutes. So make everybody hear you. Good morning, make you introduce yourself.
Morning, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, sir, for this opportunity again this morning to share little knowledge with us. We don't hear that word before, say, cleanliness is next to godliness. Abi?
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. So the matter of cleanliness, or what we go to call personal hygiene, cannot be overemphasized. Now, attitude where we supposed to maintain. Apart from this COVID-19, where they ravage the whole world now, where we call pandemic, every other disease, almost every other disease where you go see, you go discover, say, poor personal hygiene, they did the under. So, it good make everybody learn this habit. Make everybody learn this habit of being neat. Make we maintain personal hygiene. And this personal hygiene, what would they talk? So, before we go environment, now our body, now it start from.
Yes.
The same charity begins at home. Abi?
Yes.
So, the first thing first, now, within your body, how you take and maintain your body. So, we go start from there. Now, personal hygiene go start from you washing your mouth properly, washing your hands, cleaning your house, washing your clothes when you be wear. All this one are personal hygiene where each person supposed to apply every day. But you see, I'm saying, person will not do all these things when I mention so, for himself, or when not they used to run. It go hard for him to come maintain the environment. Now make I talk, say, charity begins at home. So that's this thing where you choose one now, that's COVID-19, where you say we don't return back.
Yes.
Not be lie, oh, we don't return back where. And they're very bad because Africa, now the way we say they do things now be this, and we need to change them. Hand washing, social distancing, using a face mask or face shield. Now, three major things among others where we not supposed to go back on at all. And I go tell you the reason why a lot of African people and Nigeria don't they go back. They don't get that belief say COVID-19 not they exist. But make I tell us this morning, say whether COVID-19 they exist or not, personal hygiene supposed to be part of you. True or false?
True.
Uh-huh. So make we remove COVID-19 matter. We supposed to wash our hands every now and then with liquid soap under running water. Because this, as we do, they busy during the day. Our hand, they touch different things. You touch rail for staircase. You go touch book. You go touch table. And all these things, organisms, the way you not feel still, both they call them microorganisms. So you not feel still with your optical eyes, with your koro eye. You go touch them. If you touch them, then you go put for nose. You go take hand, take it. So naturally, all these things, not with namicals, we supposed to wash our hand. Because if you busy during the day, there is no way where your hand not go touch one thing or the other. And those things where you touch, they are contaminated. So make you remove COVID-19. Personal hygiene. Now waiting everybody supposed to do. We go help us stay away from Yamanyama disease. And anybody where no saying want to live long for this life. Yes, God now they give long life. But you get part as a person. So they maintain yourself, so they very neat. To ensure say your clothes, they wash, your mouth, they wash. When you eat, some of us will not have to brush our teeth.
Yeah.
When we in the morning, we will just carry food like this. When we wake up, we go brush. When we don't brush finish, we will come eat. That is what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to eat before we brush. Because when you eat, some debris, some small, small particles, they remain for your mouth. So now that one, now you go brush, come out. We're not going to give you tooth decay and any other thing. So the ideal way to brush our teeth is, before me, I just use that one as one example of personal hygiene. Now, when you eat now, for example, this is my morning now, you don't eat. When you eat finish, you go brush. Brush your teeth well. If in the course of the day, you can't chop snacks, so you chop different things. Did they get out? So
yes.
You use water, rinse your mouth. Then when you reach out for evening, you go eat. After you don't eat that your evening food, you will come carry tooth, brush and toothpaste. Brush your mouth well. Wash your tongue up and down. Your mouth go there clean. So when you to sleep, you will get fresh breath. Because you not eat anything for night. In the morning, all you need to do, take a glass of warm water, then eat your food when you want to take your breakfast. After you don't take it, before you brush. This one is the ideal way we were supposed to do the brush. For many of us, we did do the opposite. That one is just one example of personal hygiene. When we wear our clothes, sweat don't enter. All this sweat will enter, they be wasted. We're not supposed to wear them again. So, what we're supposed to, now to ensure that we wash those clothes, we drop them, we go wash them, wear new ones. If now all those kind of clothes, where they're expensive, where they're not being washed every now and then, as you wear and come, you go, you know, sun up, put them for wear air, you know, go feel and reach up sun, heat them small. All you try to do now to ensure that those sweat will enter,
you prevent them. Yes.
I don't know whether you still hear me.
Yeah, we hear you.
So, those ones now, some of the examples for personal hygiene. They make we look our environment proper, what you talk about. I first start with our body. You see, our environment, the reason why we get flooding problems today, the major cause now, apart from the way we build house, another cause now, the way we dispose our refuse, our dirty. We go to throw away many rain before, we go throw away dirty. Somebody go to drive, at the drive, so now, he go drink coke, he go throw him through the window. All these things, they're not doing right. We they litter our environment. At the time you litter this environment, they go come back for you. That environment, so you don't spoil, so he go come back and worry you as a person. But you feel not low, you do your thinking as normal things, we not doing normal. Inadequate waste disposal, they cause yamayama disease. If they spoil the soil where would they plant food, put. If they contaminate water, do they hear me so?
Yeah, we hear you.
So we suppose ensure say we they keep our dirty well. If you get personal car, you they drive, you eat anything, gala, whatever, leave them inside your car. When you reach out, you go sweep out to where for your waste bin for house. If not public vehicle. One of the solutions, what I say, I want to tell us this is, we suppose enact law again. Maybe we ensure say, every public bus can get waste bin inside their car. And the drivers will ensure say, when their passengers eat, then dump this thing inside that waste bin. They're not going to throw it for road. Yeah. So in summary now, maybe we get out of mind. Say, as we maintain our body, we go live long. As we maintain our environment, we go even live longer. So this matter will be talked. So yes, government will get part to play. You hear me so?
Yes, we hear you.
You know, say one of the beliefs we get for this country, before you mention anything, don't say government. Before you mention anything, don't say government. Somebody eat for us, he not feel clean himself, he not feel wash his mouth, he go call government. All this matter of personal hygiene and environmental sanitation, government get their part, but we, now our part, now in big part inside. As a human being, where you live, you suppose to clean them. You suppose to ensure say, that place they need. I put some things, say, where we go talk today, where go help us, you know, improve our environment as a person. Now, number one for this inadequate way. I don't talk of the need for us now to the wash our mouths, wash our clothes,
yes.
The bath. At least, no matter how you busy with, you shouldn't take your bath less than twice in a day, two times in a day. In the morning, you go bath. Uh-huh. You know, you feel you not get wear bath when you dey work. It's understandable. Uh-huh. That's why you not go repeat your clothes. But when you reach out for evening, you suppose bath again. Possible, put the door for your water if you not dey react. So that all the things that you accumulate during the day, you will wash out. You dey get them, so?
Yes.
So that one don't go for personal hygiene. Therefore, environmental, that's our environment.
Yes.
One of the ways we go help us for this inadequate waste disposal, now to ensure, say, number one, we go create awareness. This one might be the government part. They go create awareness about this inadequate waste disposal. Because now ignorance, now they worry most of our people.
Yes.
They don't know, say, the gutter where they block with the tea. The drainage that they block, he go call where they put the tea, go block. When it block, that thing not go flow again. When erosion come, he go call cover their house. Their credentials and everything, wahala go day. All their valuables go lost. So they don't know. Many of them don't know. So I feel that we need to create awareness. We need to sensitize our people. Because this part of the world, we they develop. We not be like Western world, they don't develop
things. Yes.
When everything they work. So we need to sensitize our people on the need for adequate waste disposal. That is, maybe they throw away our identity the way we were supposed to. Well, that one passed their goal. Number two, this one, Eric, as we don't begin to sensitize them, as say to the throw away their key anyhow, you know, good, they block our drainage and our gutters and all that, our people will begin get attitude change. You know, small, small, they go, they adopt her because speaking, they learn how to work out small, small.
Yes.
That one come past their command. Then waste managers. Now, another important thing. Some person for this state, that they pay waste managers. But to see the waste manager,
it is
very difficult sometimes. You dey hear me?
Mm.
So those waste managers, we supposed to get meeting with them. Make we ensure, say, we tell them they need to they carry waste on time. Not the same person who they pay for dirty. Dirty for they have for 2 months, 3 months, you not go see them. Don't say not so much to spoil. Now so they not see this. At the time when the dirty don't they smell, enter the house and everything, the person will begin find solution to do. I don't know that would they understand that.
Yes, yes.
Uh-huh. So waste manager, then get past to pay. If you are a paid waste manager, ensure that you go and carry your waste at the stipulated time, so it doesn't create nuisance or diseases to people, you know, that are paying you for such services. Then another one, where they very important, you know, that time where we they grow, with the guarantee that they call eco.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. You see, I'm not saying that eco. If we look them, carry light, look them well. It not be as it be that time.
That's true.
Eco. That time when they grow, they go come our house, look your backyard, look everywhere. If it be say things not their right, you know, they go sanction you, do the needful. And the environmental health department for local government, as I did talk to you, is still day on. Maybe the only thing when I know say they need now to get more manpower, because many people don't see graduates now when they don't get work for that environmental.
Yes.
So I feel say if government bring in more manpower for that environmental health department, enforcement come deep. Maybe say all these people, then visit, that they do routine check into our houses, into restaurants, into public places to ensure, say, you know, that they dispose waste properly. You go see some restaurants. If you reach there, you not go one buy food, make you chop. This one now, because nobody, they monitor them. You get them, so?
Yes, yes.
People go, they cook for dirty environment. Nobody, they monitor them. So if eco come back on board, they employ more people, then they do routine check, it will still help, you know. For example, if eco they work house to house, they must cite where you put their tea.
Yes.
Where you put their tea as a person, because they get where you supposed to build, or a waste bag, or whatever, drum, anything where you they put their tea as a person. Now, if eco they do routine visit, if they discover, say, you not get anywhere you they put the tea for your house, Of course, you don't be number one and suspect where they go, they throw their teeth for our street. They litter our street wherever they fall. Now you they go. So once it was there easy for us to catch such data. I don't know whether you get that.
Yes, yes.
So this eco matter now very, very important matter where we government need to swing into action on. It will help us well.
Not sure.
Then again, we need to separate our waste. Part of the reasons why we get problem as individuals, we don't know say our waste we supposed to separate them. We supposed to separate solid waste from liquid waste. You understand?
Yes, yes.
So all the so when you separate them, it go there easy for even the waste people we want to carry them. So many times we'll just add all of them, we'll just mix everything, join body. That one another is why everywhere with the smell and all that. So a household, learn to separate your waste, your paper, all those rubbish will be say then be solid. You're not supposed to add them, join the liquid one, maybe like all those food will be made with. You're not supposed to mix them together. You're supposed to get separate container where you can collect all this waste. It will help you too.
Thank you.
Then another the last one now.
Yes.
When I go quickly took my put for this environmental sanitation, where would they talk about? Make government also say then put street laws. We go monitor some of this inadequate waste disposal. Because you know our people, just the way we Oyibo people be, they're not they push them to do anything.
Yes.
They're not saying if they break the law, then there is a sanction for it. So they do things the way they should do it. If they beat traffic, nobody will chase them, but they will tell something. So by the next month, they will not beat traffic. So me, I also should say, make government, if they don't do their own part to ensure, say, this waste, will they dispose them well, then do their own part as government first. Then the next thing I think they should do is to ensure that there are laws that are prohibiting people from disposing waste anyhow. Good. If you throw something through the window, make you pay sanction. If now 500 naira, for example, now you pay, and you only 1,000 naira for pocket, I shall say next time, you're not going to try them. Or if you say you don't want to put money, you can't even go mobile court. You say make them clear, make them work public toilet. All this one now, small thing we keep put in place.
Not
if
sure.
We enforce them,
not
you
sure.
Know, it will help our not environment.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Wait, tomorrow morning, by the grace of God, we'll talk about this health official. I know see that they take bribe where we're in Alobo. Ilalobo, not the letter they do the writing. So we'll put match for this area tomorrow morning by the grace of God. God bless you, my brother. You do well. The way to join us today.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, my people, briefly, some of these health officials that they take Ilalobo. So, Ilalobo, not the letter in the sea road. So, even when government does set up people to monitor bribe, not the letter in the sea road, where they're supposed to enforce law, they don't agree enforce them because of Ilalobo. Ilalobo, it is spoil so many things. That's why come like I say things not a work well for our society. So we need to change our character, we need to change our attitude. So government officials, make una know they take Ilalobo so that we can implement the law. All this way they talk since law they grant. But Ilalobo, not the land in the sea road. Ilalobo na bribe, kickback. Now be the problem. Even the head official, we're supposed to they move around, they check houses, whether you your environment they clean. Anywhere they enter that big man, they collect money, they come out. Now be the problem. So things not a work well because of Ilalobo. Time done it for us to overcome the spirit of Ilalobo. Make we begin to do the right thing. So my brother, now so we go talk and reach this morning because health, cleanliness to godliness, what happened, a great game. Health is wealth. So make we begin to take care of our environment. Just as my brother Corey don't talk. Make we take care of ourselves. Make we brush our mouth. Make we eat well, especially our hand. As we come back, make we wash our hand. Very, very important. Very like me, I get a rubber for outside to wash hand. So make we even me at times, I will even forget enter house. So it's not good. Make we do the right thing so that we'll get better thing. So a lot of things will come and up with the place. Now in Lalobo, and it spread so many things. Bribe a gunje and it spoil our society. Corruption. Corruption. Even persuasion, he carry ice cream to run for road. You go catch a good general, let you see road. by the grace of God, we're going to put mouth for this so many area tomorrow, so that make we play our part. Obona ga obona obona onwa. So my brother, una do well. My name is Chidimea Apostle Alfred. No shaking. We'll continue the talking as it be. We say make we quickly talk about health this morning. Now we think God send us, now we do so, to bridge in the gap. Una do well. God bless all of una. Who don't hear, tell who never hear. We will meet tomorrow morning. If at this evening itself, we'll continue to the meet. God bless all of una. Now bye-bye.
Now we don't hear from Apostle Alfred Uyinosa. I beg, before you go, make you help us share this video to friends and family. If you never subscribe to Dan ARG YouTube, I beg, try make you subscribe. So that make you for day current with the things where they happen for Edo State. So make I leave you now, make you help us share this video. Thank you for watching Dan ARG YouTube.